everybody, and welcome back to the XsivGaming channel and Farm Simulator 2017. Today we are up to episode 39 of our Let's Play series, so if you could quickly drop us a like, it would be much appreciated. And of course, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well. So today, episode 39, what are we doing? Well, as you can see, we are currently clearing up a bit of snow that's still sitting around. We're just putting it out of the way at the moment because we are trying to clear the space up for the hayloft, or the haylofts, depending on how many we're going to put in. We're considering putting in two in this space just here. It's just the main farm entrance. I think they might as well go in there. Would make a lot of sense. But like I say, that's what we are doing today in episode 39, is the haylofts. So, we can think about what buttons we need to press. Shut that engine off there. We want to do the haylofts, like we say. They are in placeables. So we click on that one, and then move across. And there we go, the hayloft. They're £90,000 each. It's a little bit expensive, but for what it is, it should mean that we can do fairly well storing up that food, of course. I think if we put one there, and I think let's put a second one in. Don't want to have it too far apart, but at the same time, we need a little bit of space between them. Get it in the right position where we want it. There we go. So there we go. Put two of those in, and then we'll come out. We'll have a quick look at them. And like I say, what actually happens is we drop the straw, etc., down at this end. And then this pipe here sucks it all in, helps dry it all out, stores it in this shed, is basically what happens. And then when we want it, we drive under this tube, this side, and it spits out what we want, of course, is the way that it works. Now, obviously, it's not going to be as simple as just dumping the grass there. We do need to, of course, dry the grass out first, is what the process is. So, what we're going to do, let's come and put this Merlot Turbo Farmer and put that away, finish that for the time being. What we, of course, want to do is dry out some of the grass that we cut in yesterday's video. Obviously, this is being recorded straight after yesterday's video because we do need to try and get ahead with some of the videos. A few things planned for this weekend. Need to try and get a few jobs sorted out. But yeah, that's what we're looking for, a tractor. That would help. There we go. So we use the Massey Ferguson 7726, the same one we were using yesterday. Shall disconnect the loading wagon. We don't need that one at the minute. What we want to do, like I say, is dry out the grass. We want to pick up the tedder, which is just here. Connect it up. Now, as we said, I believe it's about 200,000 litres. What the those haylofts hold each. So we've just put two in. It's a good 400,000 litres of hay that we can now store. So we can now unfold that. Reach two rows or not. Turn it on, lower it down. It does just about reach two rows, I think. Luckily, we've picked up pretty much one full row already. So yeah, now it's just turning this grass that we've cut into hay, of course. Do that by using a tedder. It's like a rake, it sort of spins it round and flicks the grass up into the air, allowing the air into it, which of course helps dry it out. As we've said many times, you've got the grass dried out is of course hay. People do get very confused with hay and straw. I think that's why they've made it a sort of light green colour when it comes to the game, so that it's easily identifiable that it's hay, which of course is dried grass. So when you look at hay, bell and the straw bell, put them both together, they look very similar. Both got that sort of golden yellow colour. A lot of people do tend to get confused. Yeah, once we've done this, like I say, what we will be doing is picking up, well, I think we'll have to actually windrow it all together. I think it'll be too far apart for the loading wagon to get hold of. Let's windrow it together to make sure that we get it all in one go. Reaches, like I say. Yeah, getting some of it, but it's missing some as well, so we'll just come back to that a little bit. Not quite wide enough to get both rows. Realms of, well, maybe we should upgrade it to slightly bigger and we'll be able to reach, but yeah, quickly just do this bit. Get it all windrowed up and collected up and into the hayloft. Shall I say that's what today's about? Haylofts. It's something that's actually in the base game. And again, I think a lot of people do over time forget some of the things that are in the base game. How it could be used to help you over the seasons. Lift that up, turn that off, get it all folded up now. Tempted to actually say leave this down here as well, because this can actually go on the back of the chrome. Let's leave that down here as well. Save us when we come to cut some more. Save us doing another two trips. So you go cut, going around the field once to cut. Obviously, if you turn it at the same time as being cut, it's all going to help. Fuel management as well. Just looking at the fuel gauges, we are quite low. What we're after now, we want the windrower, don't we? There we go. Think about that as well. Please excuse the sneezing just there. Talk of hay, I think it's bringing on hay fever. So yeah, like I say, what we could do is get this windrow together. All of these different jobs that need doing to get you up to speed. Unfold that, turn it all on, lower it down. Again, same principle as before. It's like a big rake, it rakes it all together, pushes it all into that one centre row. You can get bigger windrowers. More expensive, of course. For the time being, this one should be fine for what we want. Now, of course, still waiting for that ground temperature to warm up to allow us time to get things planted. And of course, waiting for that ground temperature to warm up. Here we are on day 3, mid-spring, so we're getting through the season. Making some good progress. Like I say, we're up to episode 39 today. Not sure how many more episodes we'll be doing on this series. As we said in yesterday's video, of course, Farm Simulator 19 is, of course, out in a short few days. We'll be getting hold of it at some point, as we did say yesterday. It's on the Christmas list, as we do believe in family time. Of course, it's not in the stocking, then it will be purchased in the January sales, and we will be doing that in the early part of next year. Course, doing a week of Farm Simulator videos and then a week of Euro Truck Simulator videos. It's the way that our schedule's working at the moment. Recording videos and family life, work life, etc. It's all over the place a little bit. We get there in the end. So, let's lift that up, turn it off for a minute, turn around. And you can see there's a little bit just here we need to get the road together. same row. If you want to head up and down a couple of times, pull it all the way across. Purposes of today's video, we should leave it there. We'll fold it up. It's a pity we can't put the spin rail on the back pole with the tether, to be honest. Just like a tether and then run it straight together. It'd be quite nice to do that. Yeah, there we go, we're back in the farm. Finished with that for the time being. Oops. Pop that in there out of the way. Don't need that at the moment. What we do want is, of course, the new loading wagon that we purchased for yesterday's video. Yeah, like I said, this will pick up the grass, picks up this, the straw, picks up the hay. It's a very handy sort of wagon to have. I do believe it also carries silage as well. Don't quote me on that, but I believe it does. Lower it down, turn it on once again, like we did previously. Move over to the second row. As you can see, it starts picking up, same as it would the grass. Processes it through, and of course, straight into the wagon. In theory, what it does is creates like a big bowl. It doesn't actually wrap that bowl together, but it sort of has it in one big container then. It's okay to see what's going on. Not sure if it's quite right on the video to see where the grass mound is, blend in with the grass field. Again, we can hold what, 50,000 litres in this trailer and Strawman. Again, it's doing its job really well. I'd say 12 miles an hour. Not a bad pace to be running such a big piece of machinery. It's a pity we couldn't actually convert one of the barns that we've got to store for these kind of things. The grass and the hay. It's one of those things that does deteriorate if you leave them in any kind of pile. Grass on the inner row. Maybe 7,000 litres so far. 48,000 going up. 49,000 litres. Hear that buzzer there that says that it's nearly full. Keep it running, of course, and then we'll just start collecting some of that on the outer row that we had. Just need to come back for some more, of course. And there we go. So turn that round. So this time what we're going to do, rather than taking it into the farm, of course we drive up the back of these haylofts. Use this one first. I think let's drop it there, I believe. Click the unload button. It's dropping it out, and what that's doing is sucking it straight in to the hayloft, of course. As I say, 50,000 litres straight into the hayloft there. And then you come round, and obviously once we want to unload or actually need some of the hay, we can up into the hayloft there. Should let us do it just there somewhere. Do it there. Should actually let us put the trailer under the pipe. For some reason that doesn't actually want to let us unload that at the moment. I'll let us do that one. 250,000 litres of each one is what it will let us do. Let me do that one. Why is it not letting me do that one? Maybe it's because I need to be the other way around. But yeah, we're going to just pick up the last little bit. Load that into the silo, into the hayloft as it is, and that will of course be it for today. Today of course, like I say, episode 39, all about the hay and the haylofts. Hopefully you have enjoyed and you've learnt something. Of course you have, and you've enjoyed the video, as we say, remember to drop us a like, show us your support for the channel. It does help us grow, of course. Stuff on the gatepost as well. But yeah, if you could drop us a like on today's video, it'd be very much appreciated. If of course you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well. Again, it does show you support for the channel, it does help the channel grow. And if you share the video with family and friends or anybody else you think may enjoy, it would again be very much appreciated. Well, I would say that is going to be it for today. Thank you very much for watching this one. We shall see you in the next episode. Bye for now.